Hi everyone, and thank you very much for being here with us today for this last episode of our webinar series about the keys to design your HMI. Today I'm here with Diana Cabrera. Hello, Diana.
Hello. Hello, everyone.
Hi, Diana. So today we're going to talk about the animations. As I said, is the last episode of our series about HMI. If you want to see the previous episode, Quick Start, Libraries and Graphical Tools, you have replays on our YouTube channel, PCView Solution on YouTube. So feel free to check it out. And let's start with the animation. So we're going to cover today some concepts of animation, and then Diana will show us how it works with PCView. And at the end, there will be a question and answer session. So feel free to ask your question through the interface of chat or Q and answer of WebEx, if you like. Obviously, if you don't ask question, or if you have question after the webinar, you can always contact me, and I will be glad to answer to your question. So what is an animation? Basically, an animation allows to interact between the graphic object in PCView and the user. So that's the general definition of what is an animation, obviously. And how does that work in PCView? There's more than 60 predefined animations that you can apply directly from an object, as you can see here on the screenshot. From the menu in design mode, you access to all the predefined animation, and you can directly create your animation, one or several animation per object, per graphical object in PCView, with no script. So it's very user-friendly and very intuitive, very easy to do. You will see that with Diana right after. But there's several type of animation. Animation to change the property of an object, such as the color, text, if you display a symbol, if you want to change the position of your object, the visibility, and so on. It's also possible to use animation for action, to send a program, for example, to execute a program, to open an external software, for example, for security, and so on. There's a bunch of animation, predefined animation that you can use depending on your need and depending on what you have to do in your project. But it's also important to note that an animation is really a property of an object. It means when you create an animation, as you can see here on the screenshot, you have the properties of your object and you have the animation adding to the properties. So here we have a bit send, a display register, a register send. This is very important, and you can add as many animation as you need for one object. So stop the talk now, and I let the mic to Diana. So Diana, I'm gonna give you the presenter role. Here it is. You have the lead now, Diana.
Thank you. You see my screen?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. We can see your screen.
So this is the main window of PCView. Before we start, I want to show you that we have an OPC server to simulate. I show you the server which is connected to simulate some pump behavior. We have three variables. In the simulation, we automatically change the status when control change. So we have two pumps, pump 1 and pump 2, three variables for each one. Let's start with the animations. The first thing to do is to add a mimic. And here we are going to add some objects to animate our pump. An object like this, if we double click, we have the properties of the object. This one is a text. We can change the color. We can change the background, position, and size. I'm going to add some more to the control variable. I want to add a shape, this shape, to animate. We have to do right click and then we can access to the animate menu. As François said, we have several types of animation. Color, depending on a bit group, register, alarm, and so on. Text, this is only available if we have an object text. Image, also we can present an image depending of a bit value, a register value, a text value. We can also animate symbols. We can change position of our object. We can show or hide our object depending on a bit, register, alarm. We can also send commands, bit commands, register commands, and so on. We can run a program, an application. Link animation is used to open and close mimics. We also have security animations to log in, log out, to present user information, and so on. So, for this demonstration, I'm going to show you the command animation send bit. An animation, like François said, is a tap, add to your object. Here we can seek our variable, control for our pump one. Here we can see that there is several types of command. Reverse it, it means that if the variable command is value is 0, we change it to 1, and if it's 1, we change it to 0. We can also choose to 0 all the time, to 1 all the time. Or we can also use a different variable. So the variable value that we enter here, it's right in here. Descending mode, we have direct, label, and we also have handled, which means that if we enter here, for example, 2, our animation is going to be at 0 for 2 seconds. Here we also have l'accélérateur. The accelerator, it allows us to use a key shortcut like Control C, for instance, or Escape, Control. I'm going to show you Control T. To do the same thing, but with a shortcut. If we let this, and then we type Control T, we are going to send the command to our pump. Now I am in design mode. I'm going to pass in execution mode with this symbol, and I can test my variable. I just click And I'm going to the Application Explorer to see the value of my command. I think it was a one. I'm going to click again. Now is one. I right click. It's zero. I'm going to continue adding some object to my mimic. For instance, the status variable. This time I'm going to use another object. And I'm going to use also a new animation, color bit. I'm going to look for my status variable. Here we can add a comment. Here we can see that if the bit is off, the color will be gray. If the bit is on, it will be green. If the bit is unavailable, it will be pink. We can also change the contour. Before I continue, I want to show you something. This is an instance of this mimic. I can also add, right click here, new window. I can add a second instance of this mimic. So I can be here in edition mode and here in execution mode. So I can test my command here. I also want to add the default. To show you a new animation that is called color alarm. I have a new tab with different properties. Here I'm going to look for my variable default. Here we can see that we have the color mode dynamic or static. Dynamic, it means that it's going to take the color of our project. Static, it takes the color we have here. When the alarm is off, on not acknowledge, on acknowledge, so on. Now I will show you where we can find the dynamic colors. We go to the configure menu, preference, colors. And here we have the color preference menu. For instance, for each level of an alarm, we have a set of colors that can be changed. For example, for the level 10, if you want to change the color green for the blue one, we can do it. The other ones stay the same. It's only the color 10 that change. To simulate my default, I want to use the OPC Quick Client that I have here. I can see that it's on. I make an asynchronous write. I'm going to put zero. And now I can see that my alarm is off, not acknowledged. Like here. If I put my alarm to one, I will see the color change. Now, I'm going to show you another animation. I want to add an image. I'm going to look for it in the commands library. I will use this command selector button. And I'm going to add some animations to this new object, animesh object. To do so, I go to the animate menu, image, bit. Like for the other ones, I'm going to seek for my variable. And here I have some options. If the bit is off, I'm going to look for another image. I choose this one, stop. If the bit is on, I'm going to choose the other one, start. We could also use visibility, but it's not very good because if we use visibility, we are going to have two images instead of one here. It's not good for performance. Now I'm going to add a new animation to send the value of my command. Now you can see that I have two animations, image bit, bit sent, image bit to seek for the image. If the bit is off, we seek for this one, and if the bit is on, for this one. And I am also sent a bit. So we can test it. I think I have to wait a little bit. And we can see our status change with our button command. Now here we have all the variables for our pump one. I'm going to show you that here we have two pumps, but this is only for demo purpose. In real life, we could have 100 pumps, and doing like this, we are going to lose a lot of time. There is a concept in PCView that is called the branch concept. If you notice, I have two pumps avec three variables, and the termination is the same. It's just the branch that change. This one is a station one, pump one, CMD, and this one is station one, pump two, CMD. I'm going to use that to do a generic object. So the first thing I do, I'm going to regroup all of these objects. And then I could copy them. But if I do so, I will have to change every single animation to look for pump two. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use the branch concept. So to do so, I'm going to change this object, one animation by one. And before that, I'm going to make it a symbol that I call my pump. Here I have my symbol pump with the new icon. I'm going to look for all the animations here, and I'm going to delete everything but the end. It tells me that this variable doesn't exist. It's okay. You do the same thing for all of them. I leave only the termination. Okay, now I'm going to insert my symbol, my pump, and I'm going to do it with a branch. I go do it with the first one, pump. And I can see now that I have no warnings. And this is my pump one. Now I can do the same for pump two. I can do it by typing or by using this icon. Now I have two pumps, pump one and pump two, that have different variables. I also want to show you, because I want to know which pump is it. There is an animation that we can use. I'm going to use this object to do it. I'm going to do it a little bit longer. And I'm going to add an animation. This animation is called Label Display. I'm going to look for a variable. And I'm going to use Format. And I'm going to use that something we call chain of substitution. This one means I'm going to take the second level of my tree. Okay. Now I'm going to add my symbol. My second one, or my phase one. And I can see that I have pump one here and pump two here. And I use a label animation to show you this text. I think I forgot to tell you that we could add a comment to our object. I'm going to use this one. Here we can add a comment, and if we use add, I think I have to save. Here I have the comment I just enter. I also want to show you that we can find all the substitution chains in PCB help. I just type this and I can see here that I use this one branch segment of the containing symbol to show a local branch. François, I think I finish.
Okay, thank you very much. Don't stop your virtual machine. Maybe we will have some question after a while. I'm just jumping on the slide for a quick sum up, and then it will be time for the question and answer. So I just got back the control. Thank you very much again.
And
I share my screen. Here it is. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
All right, so just to sum up a bit, we saw that an animation is a property of an object, is associated with a variable value, and it allows several action depending on the nature and the type of the object. You cannot do the same with a text than with an image or a simple drawing. The last thing Diana showed is that the tooltip can be displayed on an animation, and it's quite easy to do. And also, it's important to note that it's possible, as you can see on the screen here, and as Diana said also, to create and to apply several animation on the same object, and you have the possibility to change the order of execution of each animation for an object. So the left animation will be executed first and then the others. So you can change this order. So in many cases can be a good idea to use this. Also, we saw that a generic animation can be connected to different variables or a set of variables depending on what we call a branch. So basically, a branch defines a kind of a common part for many variables, and this branch can be connected to several variables, and then the animation can be connected, the same animation can be connected to a different variable depending on the branch. You can use substitution also for displaying dynamic information using this kind of dash substitution character. And don't forget that the Graphic Explorer allows you to access the animation. So from the Graphic Explorer, you will be able to change, to modify your animation, which is very convenient at some point. This is the time for question and answer, if you have some. If you don't, you always can send an email after the webinar, and we'll be happy to answer. So if you have questions, this is the time to ask. Okay, so there is one question here. Can you show how to use right-click on mouse or object? How to use right-click on mouse on object? I'm not sure to understand the question. The question is if we can right-click to control an animation instead of left click. Is that your question? Start a new pop-up window. So to create a pop-up window. Okay. So Diana, can you show how to create a pop-up window from an animation?
To create, okay.
Let me share your screen.
Yes.
Okay. So you can share your screen now. So as I understand the question, here we like to know how we can open a mimic as a pop-up.
Okay. I create a new mimic here. I name it pop-up. You want to call this mimic. I'm going to use a text object. And I'm going to call the link open animation. I choose my pop-up. I'm going to use this part to include it in Mimic in this one. I also have to select the pop-up behavior from the pop-up window. And now we can test our I don't see it.
I think it's because the pop-up is too large. Maybe if you enlarge your Mimic one.
Ah, just because I maybe put it. You're right, because it was outside the window.
So
this behavior allow us to show.
If you want to avoid this kind of issue of positioning the pop-up, you can from the pop-up properties in the included properties. Here you can select the square, the gray square where you want it's the position where you want the pop-up to be opened. Compared to the call button. So here automatically the pop-up will be open. So here it was above the button, I guess, but as the Mimic is too large to be at the top of the button, so it just goes down a bit. Okay. So in this case, it's important to add, Diana, that the Mimic 2 is really embedded into the Mimic 1. It means the Mimic 2 does not exist itself. So if you go to Window, you can see that we display only Mimic 1. This is because we select in the animation link open the Mimic included in. It means that when we open this Mimic, it's a Mimic really associated to the Mimic 1. And the pop-up behavior means that if you click outside the Mimic 2, it disappears. This is done because we select in the property of the Mimic 2 the pop-up behavior. Otherwise, you will have to close the Mimic 2 manually.
We can always see it here in the Graphic Explorer, even if it's a pop-up. We don't see it here, but we can see it here. So if I click here, it's going to disappear. So this way you can know with the Graphic Explorer that we have the pop-up active.
Correct. Okay, I think it answers the question, can confirm. So there's many people and the clock is running. So if you have other question, please feel free to contact me. I can show you the contact.
I think I'm.
Yeah.
It's good. Yes.
Yeah, so if you have any other question, feel free to send me an email. Also, the replay will be available this evening on our YouTube channel, and you will receive an email to access the link, and the link will become public in 1 week, but you will be able to access to it this evening. So thank you very much again, everyone, for being us today. I wish everyone happy holidays, and I hope you enjoyed this session with Diana and I. Thank you again, Diana.
And, thank you very much.
Thank you, and see you soon for the second webinar session in February about the maintenance of a PCView project. Thank you very much, and see you soon, I hope. Bye-bye.
Happy holidays. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.